spot on top, and they have kind of a flattened spot on the bottom. So, to make our apple shape, we'll start at the top, and as we make the first curve, we'll go up a little first. And as we go around, we'll make sure that we end it with a fairly flat line, with a fairly horizontal line, and then do the same on the other side. As I'm drawing right-handed, I probably should have drawn the left part first, so I can look at it the same time that I'm drawing, so I could copy it better. But I'm going to stick with this. It looks fine. There are many uneven apples out in nature, and this will simply represent one of them. Next, we're going to put a little stem on the top of the apple. Just make it get skinny and get a little fat at the end like that. Can even put a little circle on top for dimension. Next, we'll put down our red pen and get ready to draw a leaf. Now we drew these in our last project when we were drawing the flower. And we're going to draw these the same way, or this one the same way. We're going to find a part for it to start. Right there seems pretty good. Make a long flattened out S, and then a curved line which meets it at the end. Now we'll simply place a line along the middle, indicating the vein of the leaf, and we've drawn a leaf on our apple. Now, since I've been a kid, since I've drawn as a kid, I always like putting a little friend in an apple that I've drawn, drawing a little worm. And the way to do that is to start with your red pen. Oops, almost got away from me, green pen. Really wants to roll. Taking your red pen and making a little C, like that. Next, we're going to pick up the green pen again, and we're going to make the outline of a worm. Give him a big head, and keep his body about the same width of that C. To give him a little smile, a little C right here again, a little curve, and then attach that with another curved line like that. A little curved line that way, then a little curved line that way that meets the outline of the worm, and you have a little mouth. If you want to get fancy, why not give him a little red eye, since we have both colors to play with. A little circle, and a little dot inside the circle. Now we can add some texture to this picture, of course. And we want to try to remember the roundness of the apple, what it is we're trying to portray. And remember that when we make these hash marks to indicate shadow, that the ends of them imply the shape of the apple. And this allows us to make things just a little bit more detailed. You're probably doing a much better job at this than I am. And what I did right here is I made a shadow without making an outline. And you can do that too. Next, we'll add a little bit of detailing to the leaf and the worm. A little bit of shadowing. And maybe some veins coming out of the leaf, like that. Just little lines that branch off from the center, going away from the stem, they could just look like a little sweater for him.